Hi friends, hello, hi, how are you? I hope you guys are having an amazing day today. Hello, I am so sorry. I've been somewhat of a bad YouTuber. Not really though, I act like I never post. I did post like a few videos last week, but just not as many as I normally do, and I've just been really busy. Everything's kind of like piling up with school and life, and just all of these crazy things are happening, but I promise things are gonna pick back up during Christmas time because I'll be doing Glomis, so you'll get a ton of content then, and then you'll be sick of me, so. It's a win-win. So in today's video, I don't know how long this video is gonna be, but I just have some things to say. Most of you know that I am like a die-hard Anastasia stan, okay? I love Anastasia Beverly Hills. They have been my favorite brand. If you look back from any of my videos, I have always said that Anastasia Beverly Hills is my favorite brand. I love them. I have loved them. I've bought almost all of their palettes right when they came out because I just love them. I trust them. I believe in them as a brand. I've loved their aesthetic. They've put out good quality products. There's been a couple products they've come out with, like I really hated the bronzers, and obviously I didn't like the original version of Subculture. Those were kind of misses. Overall, everything I tried from them was just quality. I loved the way using their products made me feel. I loved how easy it was to use their products. I am
a stan.
So that is why I am coming to you today to talk to you about the sudden fall of Anastasia Beverly Hills. And I think it's something that's important to talk about as a makeup community. Not that it's important. There are more important things in the world. Let's make that very clear. However, I do think it's a really interesting topic because I think the way that I felt about ABH, where I was like stan level, which I am not like that with anything. A lot of people were like that with ABH. Like a lot of people have great respect for them as a brand, have great respect for the company, really respect like the owner's coming up story, really respect the products. Like, I don't think the way I felt was a singular opinion. I think most people felt that way, right? Up until this year, I think it was pretty safe to say that Anastasia was one of the most popular, more high-end makeup brands that also was very scandal-free. Because you can make an argument that like Jeffree Star Cosmetics or ColourPop were also very popular and sold a lot of products, and that's true, but ColourPop is in a league of its own, and we could talk about them in a whole separate video, and Jeffree Star has had a lot of controversies. Anastasia was like one of the most popular, safe brands to really like, right? And I think a lot of people felt that way. And then in the span of the last like 5 months, my respect, and I think the community's respect as a whole for Anastasia, has just absolutely plummeted. And I wanted to dissect why that is. Like, why a brand that was so popular and so respected and so loved, every time they come out with something now, people are posting like LOL, like people are posting like, what is going on? Why is this happening? We don't want this, which has never been the case with Anastasia. So let's do a brief history lesson, okay? Let's go back to school with Dr. Smokey, okay? So back in the early days, they put out palettes like the Makeup by Mario palette. They did a collab with Amreezy, like the OG Amreezy collab. I believe they had another collab that was like the World Traveler palette or something like that. But the big thing that I feel put them on the map, the Makeup by Mario palette kind of, but the big palette that I feel like was a boom for Anastasia Beverly Hills was the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. Now before that, they had definitely been known for their brow products because the brow pomades and the brow wizzes definitely changed the game for how companies produce eyebrow products. I don't think that's really up for debate. They kind of pioneered the eyebrow game, which is really cool, but the ABH Modern Renaissance palette put them on the map, put them like on a global scale. I think personally, it wasn't even just that that palette was good. I still have that palette. I still use it. I still really like it. I still think it's a good palette, but I think it wasn't like the most amazing palette to ever come out. But however, I think it came in a perfect storm. The Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance came out right when beauty YouTube and beauty YouTubers started really, really picking up and becoming more and more popular. They kind of got in right as the bubble started to form of makeup, and now everyone's obsessed with makeup, and like makeup's a $1 billion industry. And like, not that it hasn't always been, but there's definitely, because of beauty YouTube, been a real insurgence of people being super, super interested in makeup. So they put that out right when that was all starting to form. It was in an era of the Urban Decay naked palettes and like very cool toned, very like neutral palettes. And this was like the first of its kind, not first of its, you know what I mean? This was something different, right? When everyone was looking for something different, which was a red crazy warm tones, like, oh my god, we can put orange on our eyes and we look good. Like, it was nuts, okay? So they came out with that. They rode the modern renaissance train, like, for a while. I remember I got into makeup right when modern renaissance came out, and I finally got one for my birthday, and I was like, I want every palette they've ever created, and they only had modern renaissance. So then slowly they put out subculture, flopped. But honestly, my friend Lacey swears that the newer versions of subculture they've like fixed. I don't care to find out. The color story doesn't scream to me, but like, subculture definitely did flop. That was like a big sort of scandal. But they followed that up closely with the Prism palette, which wasn't amazing, but it wasn't subculture. Like, it didn't have the same problems that subculture had. It was just kind of like a weird sort of palette, right? And then they had the Omrizy collab, where they did the Omrizy highlighter. And I think that was another big moment for them, because it was the queen of glow. It was Omrizy. And then it was like this beautiful highlighter that was very flattering on all skin tones. They really, really, really hyped it up. Also with that came the launch of the Norvina palette. This comes in handy later. I thought it was weird at the time that the Norvina palette was named after Norvina. For those of you that don't know, Anastasia is an actual person. And she's, I believe she is the CEO. Like, she is still in charge technically of the entire company. But her daughter, Norvina, is kind of taking creative control of the brand. And it seems to me like she runs kind of like day-to-day stuff or whatever, but Anastasia is still like in charge. Okay. I thought it was weird that they were coming out with the Norvina palette. Something really important to note about Norvina, because I think she is a person that I'm going to be critiquing a little bit in this video. Something important to note about her is that she is not an influencer. Like, she in and of herself is not a social media personality. Like, we know very little about her really, because she doesn't have like a YouTube channel where she posts. She has an Instagram and she has like 1.5 million followers there. But that, in today's world, like, that's not even that many. Her Twitter doesn't have that many followers, like, comparatively to other social media people. So I always thought it was weird that Norvina came out with her own palette, because it was like not like a collab with an influencer that you know and love or anything like that. I didn't know anything about Norvina, and I was like a stan of ABH. I didn't know anything about Norvina until that Norvina palette came out. And that's why I want to touch on this, because I feel like they came out with Soft Glam, they came out with Sultry, they came out with all the, you know, all these other palettes that I loved that year, right? That was in 2018. I loved all those palettes. I thought they were fantastic. They were spread out, they were well done, they were like cultivated, they were beautiful, right? But the Norvina palette always stuck out to me as kind of strange. So cut to this year, 2019. So the very first launch of 2019 was their first really like colorful palette. It was the Riviera. I bought it first day, didn't even wait for reviews. It's an okay palette. It's not my favorite, but whatever. Then very shortly after the Riviera palette launched, we got into Melissa Edwards palette, which kind of I felt like was weird, because they were pretty similar, especially in certain ways. And I felt like it was kind of strange to kind of dull the Melissa Edwards sparkle with the Riviera palette, because I had just bought the Riviera palette. So I wasn't super interested in getting the Melissa Edwards palette because there were similar colors from the same brand. I thought that was a little weird, but I didn't really think much of it. And then we got the Jackie Ina palette, which is a beautiful palette. It's stunning. It's gorgeous. I ended up getting it and I really, really, really like it. Okay. The Jackie Ina palette was stunning. However, this is when we get into controversy. So we're at like 2019 now, mid 2019. Norvina and ABH start launching so many things. We had all three of the Norvina Pro palettes. We had the Carly by Belle palette, which is nutty. We have now two mini Norvina palettes. And then we also got a foundation, a powder, like all of these things were happening with the brand. They're constantly launching stuff. In the span of 4 months, they launched 8 palettes, which is just the polar opposite of what's been going on recently. What had made the brand so successful, what had made people love them, was their kind of exclusivity. When Anastasia was about to launch a new palette, it was like a big deal. There was so much hype surrounding that launch, right? And now all of a sudden, she's launching 2 palettes a month and it feels like ColourPop, right? So she's launching the 2 palettes a month and people are starting to get overwhelmed. And the first excuse that was given was there was a production issue. So initially, Norvina, when all of these big pro palettes were coming out, Norvina's initial response was that there was a production issue and that these palettes were supposed to be released at separate times throughout the year and spaced out more, but because of this production issue, they couldn't allow that to happen. Which I had an issue with this explanation, because my biggest problem with the, especially the pro palettes, regardless of the influencer palettes and how they totally just like didn't give Carly or Jackie any of the attention or moments to shine that they deserved on their palettes, regardless of all of that, putting out the palettes, the pro palettes, in the order that they did was shady. Making it so, you thought the first palette was gonna come out and then you were gonna have another like 6 months to save for the second one or see what the second one looked like. And then dropping all of them within the span of a month is shady. Not if you're gonna, if you know you're gonna have to launch all of these around the same exact time and you know you're gonna have to put them out, why are you not putting them all out at the same time so people can pick the one that they like best and then buy that one? It's shady because you put one out and then you put out another one that everyone might want. Like, do you see what I'm saying? To put them out separately like that, but still very close together, means that the people who ordered the first one, like right off the bat, the dedicated buyers, they don't get a chance to see what else is being offered to them. They don't get to see the entirety of what they could be getting because you're spacing out these launches in a very weird and convoluted way and still in a very short amount of time. So it doesn't give people time to save or to actually make informed consumer-like decisions. And because Anastasia palettes always sell out, there was a huge hype around the first Pro palette that the other two Pro palettes didn't really get. So that was the whole issue. Then Norvina switched gears. So now, as somebody asked her on Twitter, like, why she was putting out so much, because she was putting out like glitters, lashes, craziness, okay? Somebody asked her on Twitter why that was the case, and she switched gears. Now, it wasn't a production issue. Now, she was steering the brand towards marketing trends. She said, brands have to move way quicker nowadays because that's what the consumer wants. The consumer wants a lot of options. Anastasia Beverly Hills was getting left in the dust. And she felt like if they weren't putting out more products a la ColourPop, that they weren't giving the consumers what they actually wanted based on this, like, what marketing research did you go to find out that we want more reasons to spend money? We're over it. Like, nobody wants to keep spending all of this money on makeup. Nobody wants to go into a Sephora and casually drop $180, which is how much your three Pro palettes together would cost. Nobody wants to do that. Nobody needs this many options, especially from a brand that before was known for quality, was known for putting out some of the best formulas, was known for being just an upstanding, unproblematic brand. Who did the marketing research and who asked you for more palettes and this abundance? Like, who? The only time I can think people would have been asking you for more makeup would have been in like 2016 to 2017 when there was like a year-long break between the Modern Renaissance and the Subculture launch. Like, that was probably a little too long to wait to launch a palette. But putting out two palettes a month for the past 4 months is ridiculous. So then that was her excuse, was we're trying to keep up with the times. Anastasia Beverly Hills is just not cutting it in today's world, which I don't believe for a second. I don't believe for a second that Anastasia Beverly Hills is like suffering in any way, shape, or form, that they needed to change up their strategy. I didn't buy this from the get, because they are one of those brands that when I tell people I do YouTube or that I talk about makeup on YouTube, people are like, oh, do you know of Anastasia Beverly Hills? Like, they're a well-known brand even outside of the YouTube sphere. You don't have to be a makeup lover to know about the Brow Wiz, okay? So that was first and foremost. Now, this is what prompted me to make this video, was the third excuse that she has now given. Today or yesterday, I can't remember, she posted on Instagram basically saying that now Norvina, the girl who's made all these palettes named after herself or whatever, the creative director of Anastasia Beverly Hills, Norvina is now going to have her own little gondola at Sephora, meaning her own little end hub. She posted a picture of it, what it's gonna look like, where all of the Pro palettes are gonna be there, all of the lashes, all of the crazy glitters, and now she's launching two more additional palettes that are mini palettes. And she said she was so incredibly honored for this opportunity. She said initially the Pro palettes were going to be separated out, but because of the way Sephora wanted to do it, Sephora wanted to give her her own section in the stores, and she didn't think she'd ever get another opportunity like this. So now Norvina is launching her own subsection of Anastasia Beverly Hills that is specifically her. It's her vibe, it's her kind of brand, but it's still in under the umbrella of Anastasia Beverly Hills. The Norvina stuff is over here and normal Anastasia stuff is over here. So the Jackie and Carly palettes are part of Anastasia and all these other ones are part of Norvina, right? If this is what was actually the case, and I believe this is actually what the case was, why didn't you just announce this from the beginning and launch all of this stuff together? Why has there been separate launches mixed in with the Anastasia launches for the past 4 months that nobody has known what's going on, and you've lied multiple times now about the reasoning for it? If all along you just wanted your own gondola at Sephora that said Norvina on it, why didn't you just say that? Tarte very successfully launched a whole subsection of their Tarte brand called Sugar Rush. That's, I mean, it worked. They did a whole collection all at once. They said, this is Sugar Rush, this this is a separate part of Tarte. It's gonna be catered to XYZ, like this is what it is. Like ColourPop has done this with like multiple things at this point. They did it with skincare. Now they have the Sol thing with like the body shimmers. I don't know. Estee Lauder, I'm pretty sure, did this with the Estee Edit, which that wasn't very successful, but they still did it. Like Estee Lauder had Estee Edit. That was a completely different, it was still part of the brand, but it was like a subsection. This isn't that like groundbreaking or uncommon of a thing to do, but the way she went about doing it was stupid, because this whole time, all of us have just been like, what is going on? We don't want to buy these palettes. I saw the mini palettes today and all I could do was roll my eyes because it's so stupid. Because all of the people that bought those big pro palettes, a big criticism I saw, and a criticism I have, because I have some of the pro palettes because I'm a fool, and a big criticism I saw was people wishing that they could have those smaller palettes, wishing that they could have those palettes in a mini version because the palettes are very big and very bulky. So now that you've already bought those palettes, it's too late to return them via any return policies. Now you have an option to buy similar colors in a mini size. It's just insane to me. It's so deceiving. It's so tricky to try to get people to buy crap. That's the only explanation I can have for this type of release schedule, is to try to trick consumers into thinking this is going to be the big launch and then it's not. Like, that's my issue with this. And then to say all these different reasonings that's just not true and then like add them all up and everything, I guess technically her reasoning of like trying to keep up with consumers and stuff could be a reason for wanting to do the Norvina gondola. Personally, I think a bigger thing about it is Norvina is trying to establish herself a little bit more as less of just like a businesswoman and more of like somewhat of an influencer, which I find kind of weird, because it's like, I don't, no offense to Norvina, because like she's cool and she seems very nice on Twitter and everything, but I don't really care about the people that are making my makeup. Like, I felt the same way when Jared Blandino and Kat Von D did that stupid collab together where they like wrote messages to their fans and it was like pictures. It was like you could buy little makeup bags that were shaped like their dog. I don't particularly care about the owners of these brands. I think the only people consumer-wise who care about Norvina as a person are people who are on the ABH PR list or are trying to get on the ABH PR list. I think those are the only people that actually care about Norvina as a person. An average makeup consumer, I don't care about Norvina. I'd rather just keep having ABH the way it is. Good quality makeup that I know is dependable, that's released at a normal time frame. Like, those are the things I care about as a consumer who loves the brand. I have no interest in these little crappy mini palettes that are way overpriced. I had no interest in the Carly by Belle palette, and honestly, if I hadn't just been bombarded with three pro palettes, I probably would have been more interested in that palette. But because I was just bombarded with all this craziness that didn't make any sense with the brand, it was ridiculous. I just feel like Anastasia is digging themselves into a very deep hole with this. I feel like a lot of people I've seen are like pissed off about this. I feel like a lot of people I've seen have no interest in buying from the brand anymore because it's just been too much. And I hope that they listen, because I am rooting for them. I love them. I love them as a brand. I think the story of how Anastasia started the brand is so inspiring. Like, I love them as a brand. I really, really do. And I hope that they listen to consumers and they can start going back in an upswing. And I'm sure they're making a ton of money. Like, I'm sure money-wise, they're doing just fine. But I hope they can go back in an upswing of being a consumer favorite, because at this rate, they're just tanking the brand. I don't know. I'm very interested to hear what you guys have to say about all of the marketing that's been going on with them, everything that's been happening with them, what they've been putting out, like the rapidness of their releases. Like, please let me know what you guys think. I'm very, very interested to hear what you guys have to say on all this. Like, I'm wondering if I'm just crazy, but I don't think I am in this regard. I love you guys so much. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please like and subscribe, or just like, or just subscribe, or do neither. Honestly, just so happy you're watching me. Thank you so much for being here. My merch, Spooky Glow merch, has been extended to November 15th. My social media and everything I'm wearing on my face will be linked down below, along with a link to register to vote. That's right. You can go register to vote right now in your local, state, and federal elections, and you can be part of active change in the United States. If you're not from the United States and that link does not apply to you, please make sure you're staying informed on what's going on in your country. Make sure you're using your voice in a positive way. The world definitely needs more of that. And yeah, I love you guys so much, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.